Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. I hope you all alright and I hope you all had a good weekend. We are here today to do some PlayStation VR news on Sunday, so kind of chilled news. We're gonna just chat a bit about few games. We're gonna talk about the Swordsman and brand new way to play this game, but also a bit of updates on Blade and Sorcery and Hellsplit Arena for PlayStation VR, of course. So we're gonna begin maybe from the Swordsman as the update coming soon. Of course, the game hugely popular among everyone. You see in the background here, this is the trailer for Dismemberment update and also Pirates faction update, and it was pretty cool. You chopped some skulls, you shoot some people, but the another update is incoming. I'm gonna bring it here. So this is the grappling update, and you can see on that screen somebody is being choked, and that's what you're able to do in this latest update. So it's not out yet, maybe I just bring it up a bit so we can properly see the window. So basically what the developer is saying is no sword, no problem. Hand-to-hand combat comes to the Swordsman in 1.28. Expect this update in June. Punching and grappling with enemies, the ability to disarm opponents, which gonna be pretty cool, and full physics for collisions between your body and the environment. So that's a very, very nice update, something what was kind of requested a lot by pretty much everyone. So it brings us closer to this Blade and Sorcery kind of and Hellsplit Arena gameplay style. So even if you drop the sword, you can grab them, punch them, you can grab their weapons as well. So you know, you can chop them to bits now, but also you can play around with, you know, punching them. So that's pretty cool. But apart from that, what the developer is saying as well, so I'm gonna talk a bit about update 1.27. Slightly delayed, this is the update that gonna bring us the PlayStation 5 updates for the game, so the game will look better for PlayStation 5 owners. And what they saying is the 1.27 update, which comes before the hand-to-hand update, is expected to come in the day or two, so just around the corner. We run into some problems testing on the PlayStation 5 dev kit. Just need to verify that the PS5 enhancements work as intended before deploying. So all the patch notes and everything for the upcoming patches can be found in the roadmap. And also we're gonna have a look at this roadmap in a second. But yeah, very good update once again, so that's pretty cool, but anyway, let's check out the roadmaps. So you know what's coming and you know what to expect, so their considerations are adding co-op and also some social features, but also they thinking about adding multiplayer, player versus player, PlayStation VR China Point, lore and loading screens, portable blacksmith, that pretty cool, input remapping, nice, and no helmet option. And of course there is another update already in the development. After update 1.28, the update 1.29 will come, and in update 1.29 you can expect it late June or sometime in early July, they don't know yet. But advanced weapon handling, so you probably gonna be grab the weapons in like a multiple contact points, that's what I'm assuming. Also they gonna add weapons physics and weights, you know, all of it gonna be overhauled and improved. Same goes for the enemy physics, they planning finish him feature slash executions, and something to be announced. So yeah, very, very nice updates for the Swordsman. I really like them, they working hard on this game, so definitely you can expect good thing. So let me know in the comment section what you're thinking about it. I think it's very, very nice. But anyway, let's speak maybe about some the Hellsplit Arena, because you want to know about this game as well. So first of all, the latest update on the PC released, and it's a pretty nice update. You can see down there playing in the background. Basically you're riding horses and you're killing people. So you know, it was very original as well. Kind of made Hellsplit bit of nice alternative to all other physically based combat games because of course of the ability to ride animals. Now, we all waiting for this PlayStation VR port, and what's happening is maybe it's me, maybe not. The developers, of course, said in past that they want to bring this game to PlayStation VR and they're gonna try to do it this year. They said it on Twitter at the beginning of the year. Let's have a look. So yeah, basically they was asked, maybe this has been asked, but I haven't found any info, any chance this is coming to PlayStation VR. And what the developer said is, hello, hope to make it this year. Now, I need to give the credit to this developer because they really trying hard to bring it to PlayStation VR. It's not at all that they don't want to bring it, but of course there is more challenges for the smaller studios. So they kind of couldn't do it just yet, but they definitely trying it. Now what I'm thinking is maybe now PlayStation VR is getting late to its lifespan and definitely from what I played on the PC you kind of need more accurate tracking and also you really need those thumbsticks in HellSplit plus the 360 tracking helps a lot as well. So maybe it's just the best to wait for PlayStation VR version, PlayStation VR 2 version. I don't know, maybe it's gonna be cross-platform, they're gonna release it on PSVR, and when PSVR 2 releases, maybe they're gonna do PSVR 2 version. I kind of don't really know, but you know what, I wish them all the best. They've been trying hard for over a year or so now, yeah, about 2 years. To bring HellSplit to PlayStation VR, but of course they've got some limitations. When it comes to the budget, of course, it's a smaller studio with not the big money behind them. So probably a lot of sacrifices from the developers. And also, of course, they need to still support PC version because that's the version everyone plays because it's only out on PC. So definitely, even though they trying hard, I don't know, I kind of feel for them because everyone wants to play this game. Not only PlayStation VR owners, but also Oculus Quest owners. And they trying to do everything to actually bring it, but of course the resources might be the issue. Smaller number of people on the team, you know, it's hard to do for them. But they said they're gonna try PSVR this year, so just to let you know. But for me, at least, I don't know. I would like to play it on PlayStation 5, on PlayStation VR. But I would like to play it on the same state as it is on the PC without any compromises. But let me know what you're thinking. I mean, Move controllers probably could pull it off just. I think with heavy optimizations, even if they would have to downgrade graphics to run it on PS4, it's the gameplay what's fun in HellSplit. So you know what, those graphics, what you see in the background, probably running on high-end PC, and that's how probably it would look on PSVR and PS5, PSVR 2, I mean. But on PlayStation VR 1, I don't know, they probably could pull off something similar, maybe not as advanced, but they could do it. So that's the bit of info about HellSplit for you. Okay, so now let's speak a bit about Blade & Sorcery, another game that everyone wants. Of course, rightfully so, it's a very fun medieval slasher. And what's happening is, I mean, I've done tons of videos about it, but anyway, let me bring you the little update, what we can have a look and what we can find out. So this is the roadmap, update 11, it's scheduled for third quarter of this year, 2021. And then final update, update 12, it's targeted for fourth quarter, so end of this year. And they're gonna add some new stuff and spells and things like that. And of course, after that, to be defined is Oculus Quest release and also PlayStation VR release. Now, that's what we know from those updates. And you know what? The update, so Q3, we like gonna enter it very, very soon. And also the in Q2, we meant to get update 10. But let's have a look at the Steam, because it looks like something's got delayed. So here we are on the Steam in their website, you know, it tells you about the updates and what the game's got. So they currently on the update 9.3 version, just a little, just removed Unity XR plugin, apparently been causing some issues for some people. But that's not what I wanted to talk about. Basically, the update 10 was scheduled to release in the third quarter of this year. And of course, third quarter is gonna be with us in 2 weeks' time, so update 10 probably delayed. And as we know, everything gets delayed those days because of course of the pandemic. But yeah, I wouldn't expect them to start any work on the other ports until they've done all the updates and the PC version is totally complete after update 12. So what is looking like to me, basically the update 12 won't even be out this year. It's gonna be out probably next year. And also I would now kind of abandon hope for this generation PlayStation VR version of Blade and Sorcery. But I would say this, it's probably gonna come out on PlayStation VR 2. That's my best guess. I mean, I'm not 100% sure, but if Sony releases next headset, hopefully next year, if all the updates for Blade and Sorcery gonna take such a long time, like somewhere middle of next year or something, then I wouldn't be surprised if the developer just waits and releases on PlayStation VR 2. I mean, I'm not sure about it, but that's what I'm expecting. But who knows, they might surprise us. Okay, so that was our little chilled Sunday news, slightly different format. You know what, I was feeling like doing it differently. So sometimes I might do it that way, I don't know. But let me know what you think, whatever. And also, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.